The Senate is lukewarm to President Duterte's appeal to fast-track the passage of the second round of the tax reform law.
That's because of the possible effects, particularly on employment. Shaila Francisco has the report.
This matter is urgent. Do not be part of the problem by ignoring it. I hope to sign package though before the year ends. I urge Congress to pass it in form that satisfies our goals and service.
In his third State of the Nation address, President Duterte personally appealed to lawmakers to pass the second package of the government's tax reform program. Under the second tranche, corporate income tax will go down to 25% from the current 30%. It also aims to rationalize incentives to attract new and growing industries that can contribute to national development. In his speech last Monday, Duterte sees this as a way to help micro, small, and medium enterprises and create more jobs. But the Senate is lukewarm to the second tranche of the tax reform program. Senate Majority Leader Migz Zubiri even revealed that no senator wants to sponsor Train 2.
I know the president wants us to tackle Train 2, but alam mo, ninenervyos na kami dito sa mga train na ito.
Zubiri explains the Senate needs to look at the possible job losses due to the proposed changes to fiscal incentives.
Lahat na nakausap ko ng industries, wait and see, because gusto nila tingnan, mawawala ba incentives nila? Kasi kung mawawala, lilipat daw sila ng ibang bansa. I don't want to lose jobs because of this, and we don't want to lose also opportunities for jobs in the future.
But Budget Secretary Benjamin Jokno clarifies, not all incentives will be removed.
We are rationalizing it. There are some 200 plus fiscal laws, right? That's too messy. We will limit the incentives to performance-based, time-bound, okay, verifiable.
Jokno stresses it's the responsibility of lawmakers to respond to the demands of the president. For now, he's hopeful that Train 2 and all other packages will be passed before the year ends. Jokno says they've already submitted all packages to Congress.
It's nearing an election. Tax is usually unpopular, so they will not touch it. So you can say goodbye to it, okay? It's either this year or forget it, because 2019 is an election year. That's my own assessment. If it's not passed this year, then we will refile it under a new Congress.
Jokno reveals they plan to convene the Legislative Executive Development Advisory Council, or LEDAC, to address the issue. Shaila Francisco, VR1 News.